Hi, welcome to the 4th annual Buckeye Showcase here in the Ohio Union. I'm your host, Chase Curtis.
And I'm Andrea Henderson. Tonight we have some exciting and talented acts being put on by your fellow Ohio State students with hopes of winning some great prizes.
Yeah, some great prizes indeed. They range from $150 to $350 based on three categories: performance, originality, and overall score.
The judges for tonight's show are Vice President of Student Life, Dr. J, along with the homecoming Queen and King, Anuj Bhandari and Eliza Bruches. First, we're going to talk to Lauren and hear what the judges have to say about tonight's show.
I'm here with two of tonight's judges. First, we have Eliza Brooks, who is the homecoming queen, and Anuj Bhandari, who's the homecoming king. So, Eliza, what kind of performances are you most looking forward to tonight?
I'm excited to see what original and creative things people have come up with. I've seen some really great costumes so far, and so I'm really excited to see what kind of acts they're going to bring about.
And Anuj, what kind of characteristics will you be looking for in a performer?
Yeah, so whenever I'm watching talent shows on TV in my local city or at Ohio State, I always look for things that warrant an emotional response, so things that really make you feel something.
And can you guys tell us a little bit about the judging process, what's that's going to be like?
Yeah, so there are a couple different categories. We're going to have a top overall performer, a top vocal, a top dancer. We'll have one for originality and creativity, and then I think there's a winner for the audience vote as well.
Mm-hmm. All right, well, I'm sure you guys are going to have a fantastic time judging tonight's performances.
Yeah. Very excited.
Thanks, Lauren. Now we have coming up Buck That, an exhibition act for this year's talent show.
Check. I was looking for a breath of life, a little touch of a heavenly light, but all the choirs in my head sing no.
To get a dream of life again, a little vision of the sun at the end, all the choirs in my head sing no, no, no.
But I needed one more touch, a little taste of devouring rush, and I believe it's so.
And I needed one more touch, another taste of devouring rush, and I believe it's so.
Down to my leg, but the room was so quiet. So,
breath of life, and I started to lose my mind. It was a chorus so sublime. The room was so quiet. Oh,
I was looking for a breath of life, a little touch of a heavenly light. All the choirs in my head sing no.
To get a dream of a life again, a little vision of the sun at the end. All the choirs in my head sing no.
I'm here with tonight's first competing group, Dynamic Contrast. So can you tell us a little bit about your act tonight?
All right, well, we are doing an intro, and then we have the song Grenade by Bruno Mars. And from there, we are transitioning into a mashup written by Alfred Kimbrough over there. It's a mashup of Rumor Has It and The Edge of Glory.
And you guys are an a cappella group,
yes,
correct?
Yes, we are an a cappella group.
Okay. And is this your first time performing at an event like this?
This is not, actually. 3 years ago, there was a Buckeye Showcase, and we were at the one 3 years ago. And it was a blast, and we loved it, so we're back again.
Okay, and what would you guys do with the prize money if you won?
Well, we're actually working on developing an ICCA set for next year, which ICCAs is the International Competition for Collegiate Acapella. And we're going to use that money to like improve our musical ability, buy music, and just pretty much invest it all towards a group.
And how long has this been a group at Ohio State?
Since 2009.
Okay. And is there anything else you'd like to add about your performance tonight?
Yeah, well, all the music we have is written by our own music directors, so it's to the extent of a cappella original to our best ability, and we're very much looking forward to performing for all of you.
Okay, well, good luck to all of you guys tonight. I'm sure you guys will do an amazing job.
Yes.
That's just how you live. Oh, take, take, take it all, but you never give. Should have known you were trouble from the first kiss. Had your eyes wide open. Why were they open? Gave you all I had and you tossed it in the trash. Tossed it in the trash, you did.
Tossed it in the trash, you did.
To give me all your love is all I'd ever asked for. What you don't understand is I'd catch a grenade for ya.
Yeah, yeah,
throw my hand on the blade for ya.
Yeah, yeah,
I'd jump in front of a train for ya.
Yeah, yeah,
you know I'd do anything for ya.
Yeah,
you won't do the same if my body was on fire. Oh, you watch me burn down in flames. You said you love me, you're a liar, cause you never, never, never did.
Welcome. We're glad you could join us today. We hope you enjoy your visit to the Haunted Mansion. You'll find there are surprises around every corner. Here, anything is possible. I assure you, everything is real. Nothing is a trick. There are some interesting characters around. Don't mind their fangs or their screams. If you happen upon a few of them, don't be afraid.
Okay. Better than immersive. Your chicks be so thirsty. I'm in that 2C Lambo with your girl. She trying to jerk me. Better than immersive. Your chicks be so thirsty. I'm in that 2C Lambo with your girl. She trying to jerk me. Better than immersive. Your chicks be so thirsty. I'm in that 2C Lambo with your girl. She trying to jerk me.
Please, don't. The only reason we wander these halls is because we're in search of our lost loves. What was that?
Dr. Jekyll, did you hear that scream?
What scream? I was too busy with my work, but I think I perfected my formula.
I'm backstage with Aaliyah Jackson, who just came off the stage performing. Can you tell us a little bit about how you felt out on the stage?
Well, at the beginning, I was kind of nervous, but as the song went on, I just kind of let loose and it came out.
And was it true that your microphone was not on at the beginning of the performance?
Yes,
how was that?
Yes, yes, it wasn't on. And when he came out and brought me, I just took the mic and was like, well, here I am, so.
And what song did you sing tonight?
I sung I Believe in You and Me by the late Whitney Houston. And I hope that I did her justice tonight.
How long have you been singing?
Since I was about 6, so that's maybe about 10 or 12 years.
Well, you sounded amazing. Good luck to you with the judging.
Thank you so much.
Back to you, Chase and Andrea.
It was blissful ignorance, a love imitation dance my heart performed as you juggled it in the air. It flew with graceful ease, unaware of the tease, foolishly thinking it had security. Well, I promised myself I'd be less quick to leave the ground, but it only took a moment, now I'm upside down. And though I'm all for believing in happy endings, I've seen the outcome when we act like we're pretending. sing, so please, though it's tempting to play, remember it's not a game. It's funny how we plan, how we think we can change our tendency to fall. Well, they're starting to call me queen of unreciprocated love. They line up one by one to take it all. Well, I promised myself I'd hold it back this time, but he's come along blurring history right before my eyes. And though I'm all for believing in happy endings, I've seen the outcome when we act like we're pretending. So please, though it's tempting to play, remember it's not a game. Oh, it's not a game. So take your promises and get them out of my head. I'll take a little honesty instead, and I'll take your kind words and dig them right out of my heart.
To a pile of documents, my mind is an empty aquarium. I have been forced to sit in a special classroom where every wooden bookshelf is a reminder that I never escaped the fourth grade. Insults leak from the holes in the ceiling. This carpet is soaked with insecurities. Shattered pencils are scattered everywhere. The deceased sharpener tilting from that chipping wall. I have watched bulletin boards tear off at normal lesson plans. It is tired of being ridiculed by the whispers crawling beneath the muddy doormat. The disfigured words on a blackboard spells brainless, and the chalk powder is poison in my brain cells. I am convinced that my imagination is below grade level. The ruptured legs of my desk is buckling at the body mass of my sorrow. There is caution tape wrapped around this classroom. Every student without special needs glares through the tiny windows. They see nothing but corpse gasping for wisdom. I hear college don't have classes like these. I have developed frightening routines. I usually jump out of my desk, run to the back of class. I take cover. I don't want anyone to see me in a room infested with misspelled words. When anyone asks me, what is your favorite class? I smile in eerie burden. I tell them fire drills, tornado warnings. These are only two times. I feel normal when the alarms are blaring. The chalkboard crumbles into dust. The nails of my desk loosens. It falls apart. I entangle the embarrassment in my fist. I pick up all the broken pencils. I carry them with me. Whether if I was dying or dead, my carcass feels alive with pride bleeding from my left shoulders. I walk with my peers. I am not a wheelchair. These hallways do not separate us by the diagram of our brains. We are all enclosed in the same cranium. My imagination is sandcastles, the cells in my mind above grade level. This is what college must feel like. My brain and spinal cord never felt this connected. As I bypass my library, my confidence becomes hardcover books. And these normal classrooms is where I belong. Now we all take cover. I don't need a referral to be here. And the alarm stops. My teacher reads off four names. The sharp edge of a piercing voice behind me reads off 20, I don't want to be here. We are asked to get up from our knees, head to class. The drill is over. I don't want to move. Stigma cripples activity in my bones. As I stagger to my cage, the door slams. It locks. Light bulb shatters. Red stimming eyes come peeling through the darkness. The insects of my insecurities come crawling out of my pockets, up my arms, across my shoulders, around my neck. My imperfect brain, my single file line looks like a snake, and everyone is staring with nets in their eyes.
got soul, but I'm not a soldier. I got soul, but I'm not a soldier. I got soul, but I'm not a soldier. I got soul, but I'm not a soldier.
Who just got off the stage for performing her baton routine. Can you tell us a little bit about your performance?
Well, I tried my best, and I had fun doing it. I guess that's all that matters, to show my talent.
And what did it feel like being on stage in front of all those people?
Well, I should be used to it, but I'm not. It's been a while, about a year since I performed in front of people, so it felt great to get back out there again.
And how long have you been baton twirling?
I've been twirling for 13 years.
What got you into baton twirling?
I got into baton twirling starting with my parents. They put me in it, and I've stayed with my local baton group ever since.
Okay, and what would you do with the prize money if you won?
I guess probably like everybody else, I'd put it toward college. I mean, that's what I can do, I guess.
Yeah. Well, you did a great job.
Thank you. And
good luck with all the judging and stuff.
Thanks.
Back to you, Chase and Andrea.
Freestyled for two pieces.
And when did you start getting into dancing?
I've been breakdancing for 8 years now, and I've been hip hop dancing for 2 years.
And were you nervous at all before you went on?
I actually was pretty nervous, but I used those nerves to my advantage and just made it push me through.
What did it feel like being on stage in front of all those people?
It was really exciting because all the hard work that I've been putting into dance pays off, and everyone is excited to see me.
You did a great job. You're very entertaining to watch.
Thank you.
Back to you guys. Sound of Science, an a cappella group at Ohio State who's about to go on stage. Can you tell us a little bit about your act?
We are a nerd-rific a cappella group. You can tell by our suspenders. And we just like to have a lot of fun with our music, and so we're going to hopefully entertain everybody.
Can you tell us a little bit about the song you're going to be performing?
Rhythm of Love by the Plain White Tees. We're going to do a dance and sing. It's going to be fun.
And when did your guys' group get founded?
Just 2010. I believe spring of 2010, as far as I know, after winter, whatever. Quarters.
What's going through your guys' mind right now as you're about to go on stage?
Well, this is the biggest performance that we've ever had, and it's really been an honor to get accepted to the Buckeye Showcase at all. And so we're just all really excited, I think. Pumped up.
Okay, well, I'm sure you guys are going to do great. Yeah. Good luck to all of you.
Thank you.
Back to you guys.
I told her I loved her view from up here. Walked out into my ear and watched the world from above as we sing to the rhythm of love. We may only have tonight, but till the morning sun, you're mine.
I'm backstage with Drew Murray, a magician at Ohio State. Drew, can you tell us a little bit about your act?
Yeah, so I'm a magician here at Ohio State. I try to keep my act away from the bunnies and top hats and what you think of a typical magician. It's real fast-paced, a lot of energy, a lot of modern music, and I try to keep it fun for everybody.
And how long have you been into magic?
I've been doing magic since I was 6 years old, ever since I can remember, really. I was 10 years old when I started doing shows, and then here I am, 21 years old today, so it's been great.
What got you interested in the magic?
Actually, I saw a magician at a festival at a summer carnival, and I don't remember exactly what he did, but from that moment I was hooked.
And how does it feel to be closing the Buckeye Showcase this year?
Oh, it's great. I got a lot of big stuff planned. I got a real big illusion, so hopefully everyone enjoys it.
Well, good luck to you. I'm sure you're going to do a great job. Back to you guys.
right, what I need everybody to do is count to three. You guys ready? 1, 2, 3. Hey! We gotta get out! We gotta get out! Everybody, if you enjoyed the show, if you guys enjoyed the show, my name is Drew Murray. If you didn't, my name is David Copperfield. Take care, guys. Thanks so much.
And now we're going to go to Lauren to check in with our winner.
I'm here with Deborah Lasterson, who just won Best Vocal Performance of Buckeye Showcase 2013. What does it feel like to be a winner?
It's pretty exciting. I didn't see it coming, so it's really fun.
I'm here with OSU Genesis, who just won the award for Best Dance Performance of Buckeye Showcase. What does it feel like to have won?
It's awesome. I mean, it's one of these fun performances that we love doing. It's not really a competition, but it's just, you know, all of us get out there and we're just like, you know, just hit it hard and have fun with it, and the crowd will love us. So that's just the kind of mentality we have, these kind of performances, and it's a good show.
Now, there were a lot of great dance performances. Were you guys expecting to win?
No, I mean, we honestly just came out and we wanted to have some fun. Like, we met up like yesterday to practice, and it was just like a chill night. And we loved every other act, honestly. Some of them very original, like the Poetry Slam, some of the other dance groups as well. But I guess, you know, it's just like we love having fun, and it shows off, so yeah.
I'm here with Cortez Harris, who won Most Original Performance here at Buckeye Showcase. What does it feel like to have won?
Definitely was shocked. So many great talent. It honestly did not dawn on me that I would win a check. So a humbling experience.
And is this something you would like to do again in the future?
Well, heck yeah. Well, alumni can come back. Alumni, because I graduate this semester. So if they're welcoming alumni, I will be back.
I'm here with Styles Dance Group, who won Audience Favorite at Buckeye Showcase tonight. How does it feel to be the audience favorite?
I think it feels really great to be audience favorite, because sometimes the judges don't always feel the same way. So audience, I'm glad that they liked our show tonight.
And did you guys expect to win at all?
Not really, but I did have a lot of our friends come and support us, so I think that really helped.
And would you guys, or is Buckeye Showcase something that you guys would plan to do in the following years?
Yes, we always love coming and being a part of Buckeye Showcase. I think it's a great way to get our name out there and to show people what we can do and what we've been working on.
I'm here with magician Drew Murray, who is the winner of the 2013 Buckeye Showcase, and I'm here with his assistant, Kelly. Can you tell us a little bit about how it feels to be the winner of Buckeye Showcase?
Oh, it's awesome. I put a lot of work into what I do. I build my illusions. I spend a lot of time practicing, and of course, a lot of money goes into it, so it's nice to get something in return.
Did you get a chance to watch any of the other acts tonight?
Yeah, I did. I loved it. And I loved the guy with the soccer balls, and a lot of the dance acts were really good. So it was nice to see a variety of stuff.
And who did you think was your biggest competition?
Biggest competition? Geez, I was in and out. Maybe somebody with a variety, like the soccer ball or the baton twirler, something like that.
And what's it like to be part of the act that won?
It's just a lot of fun, and it's really nice.
Okay, well, congratulations. It was well-deserved. It was a great show. I still don't understand how you guys did that stuff, but
she wants dinner now.
Back to you guys.
We'd like to thank you all for joining us here tonight, and what a competition we had.
We really had some great performances tonight, and we hope all of you at home got to join them as well.
I'm your host, Chase Curtis.
And I'm Andrew Henderson. Thank you for joining us on Buckeye TV.